WNET's Peril and Promise reporting initiative on climate change has a new series, Sinking Cities, a four-night television event exploring the impact of rising sea levels and intensifying weather. New York, Tokyo, London, and Miami are all coping with the real-time effects of rising seas and are working on solutions to literally stem the tide. Tonight, the target is Tokyo, a city plagued by typhoons, tsunamis, earthquakes, and sinking neighborhoods. As one of the world's most populous cities, what solutions have Tokyo's scientists, urban planners, and engineers found to help mitigate climate disaster? Here's a preview.
Typhoons. Tsunamis. Earthquakes. Rising seas. Liquefaction. Sinking neighborhoods. Tokyo, the world's most populous city, has the world's largest set of problems.
So when you pile up all of those elements together, so the sea level will rise 1 meter, plus the quake, that's 2 meters, plus eventually a typhoon that can bring the water level a meter higher, so that's 3 meters. And if you are unlucky, at that time you have flood from the rivers, or you have a small tsunami that are predicted to be between 1 and 1.5 meters, all piling those elements together, well, you're in deep trouble. It's not a question of is it going to happen, it's a question of when is it going to happen.
Nonetheless, Tokyo may be one of the very few cities in the world seriously grappling with the challenge of climate change. It's figured out engineering solutions before, and with sea levels rising, Japan now needs to do it again. In 1993, before climate change was much discussed, Tokyo decided to tackle its existing flood problem with a mega project that many believe was decades ahead of its time. Japan built a futuristic cavern to protect itself against water from above, below, or from the surrounding sea.
We are in the surge tank. We have come down to 65 feet below the ground. On the left-hand side is shaft number one. Further down the tunnel, we also have shaft number 2, 3, 4, and 5. The overflow from flooding is collected through these shafts and goes through the tunnel to come up through shaft number one gradually. The water then flows into the Showa drainage pump station through this surge tank.
When water floods Tokyo, this is where it all goes.
The accumulated water will rise, and eventually it will reach a certain level. Then it gets forced through the four pumps of the Showa drainage pump system to be drained out to the Edo River. We have the water flowing into our facility about 7 times a year on average. Out of those 7 times, for about 60% of the time, the water flows into here and is forced out to the Edo River. For the remaining 40% of the time, we store the water here as it can hold up to 670,000 tons. And then the water gets returned to the river it came from.
The system can hold up to 65 million gallons of water and can pump it out as quickly as it comes in. Lewis McKenna is a UK-based engineer focused on the problem of stormwater management.
For the mind's eye to capture the scale and size of these silos, you can take the Statue of Liberty and place it inside one of those silos. That's how big it is. It's quite impressive. Flooding in Tokyo is a big challenge. If they didn't have that type of protection, they will be gone.
It took 13 years to construct this facility, from 1993 to 2006. In actual figures, it cost 230 billion yen.
That's more than $2 billion.
Some domestic and international evaluations consider this to be expensive. However, the flood damages in this region have been reduced to approximately one-tenth. Therefore, I think it is not that expensive when you take the flood damages into consideration.
In 2015, after a record rainfall, this temple to engineering was filled to the brim. But the heaviest of those rains missed Tokyo, with the greater impact outside the city to the northeast. Kuniharu says the giant Showa drainage pump system could not have coped if that storm had directly hit Tokyo.
I heard it was the greatest amount of inflow and drainage since this facility began its operation. Our facility has four pumps, and we usually use one or two at a time. 2015 was the first time all four pumps operated at full capacity simultaneously for more than a week to drain the water in an effort to mitigate flooding in the region.
Once the tank is full, it drains into the Edo River at a rate of 53,000 gallons, the capacity of an Olympic-sized swimming pool, every 12 seconds. It's the most advanced flood mitigation system on the planet. But recent record rainfalls are too much for even the massive reservoirs to handle.
We do get questioned about what happens if we had a rainfall of a similar scale. And we must admit that we are not fully certain.
Sinking Cities, Tokyo premieres tonight at 10 p.m. on PBS. Check your local listings for subsequent airtimes or online viewing opportunities. So on behalf of all of the entire team at MetroFocus, have a good night, and we'll see you tomorrow.